The more hits we play, the more hits we get. URLradio.net. Stacey Sturm, Stacey and her Posse in the Morning. And in the studio with me today, I have Mary Jo Van Horn of the Secret University. How's it going today, Mary Jo?
Hello, Stacey. Well, in all full transparency, yes. I am sitting here.
Yes.
Thank God it's radio, because I am sitting here with a complete rip up the back of my pants.
It's been one of those days.
Right? I walked into a meeting right before I got here, and someone lovingly pointed it out to me. Thank goodness. I had no clue.
Oh,
and
dang.
So I sat through that meeting, and I had to stand up and talk and stuff, but I just put it out there and covered it with my top and came over here, walked across the street, and other than that, it's great.
Yeah, because what else are you going to do? You just make the best of a situation.
Exactly. And there would have been a day I would have been mortified.
Right?
Oh, yeah. I would have just walked out and went back home.
Yeah.
But you know what? It's all about your thoughts and how you look at it.
When you look at the grand scheme of things, no one's really going to remember that in a couple weeks.
Yep.
And they're not going to care even if they do.
Exactly.
So, yeah. Choose your battles. But speaking of careers, that's what we're talking about today, aren't we? So tell us about what you got, Mary Jo.
Yes. I was very intuitively called this morning to talk today about corporate employees.
Okay.
Career people. So I know there are some of you out there listening that are meant to hear this message.
Yes.
And so what we want to share today is if you are in a career and you are thinking, what's wrong with me?
Okay.
That I am not as far along in my career as I should be.
In corporate America, feelings get hurt a lot because you are passed over for committees, opportunities, awards, praises.
Promotions.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. And what happens is, you know, then, and it's kind of what you're bringing to the table, right? Mm-hmm. When we've talked the last couple of weeks about limiting beliefs.
Yeah.
Okay. And so I say this with love and respect, but you are creating that for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And most often, you have this, you tend to think and feel that your employer isn't going to promote you.
Yeah.
Right. So you're bringing that right to the table before the opportunity for promotion even comes up.
Or everybody else except for me gets recognition. I never get recognized.
I'm the only one.
I never get recognized for my efforts. Yeah.
Yep. And you're thinking the thoughts when the promotion opportunity does come up, kind of what's in your thoughts are, I'm going to get screwed. I just know I'm going to get screwed over again. You know, everybody's out to get me. That type of thing. And what I want you to hear is that there's nothing wrong with you.
Yeah.
There's nothing wrong with you. You don't have a problem. And I like to say it this way. There are no problems to be solved, just truths to be revealed.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I'm talking about when we talk about limiting beliefs.
Yeah.
Because where the truth is hidden.
Yeah.
Internally, within, right, under layers of emotions like guilt that you're not as far along as you should be.
Yeah.
Or guilt that you spent all this money on college education and you just don't feel like you're doing what you should be doing.
Yeah.
Or you feel guilty that you're not making as much money as you want to be making.
Mm-hmm.
Or guilty that your parents put you through college and you don't have much to show for it, or you're not at that level of maybe what they are expecting.
Right.
And so it's under layers of
that. I hate to let you people know, but you're never going to be at the level your parents are expecting.
Yeah, because they will always up level.
Yeah. It's good and it's bad.
But that's where, like, the truth of you is hidden under that guilt and shame, you know, sadness. You know, because a lot of times we go home or, you know, throughout the day, we just, you know, you feel sad.
Yeah.
You know, I get that. You feel alone because, you know, you think you're the only one.
Right.
Yeah. And then under layers of fear and scarcity.
Yeah.
Right. That scared you're not ever going to get ahead.
Yeah.
Scared that there's not enough to go around. You know, that there's not going to be another promotion like this one.
Right.
And what happens is that just keeps you stuck in there. And so when you can become aware of your limiting beliefs and it's like, and release them, right? Then the truth of who you are can rise to the surface. That's Does that true. Make sense?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. Yeah. And there are people too where I look at them like, you know, I am surprised they keep getting passed over for promotions. I do recognize they have talent, and I wonder what, you know, I wonder like what's going on with that.
Yeah.
And it's probably a lot of self-fulfilling prophecy where they're like,
yes. And it, yeah. And how, right, how you are feeling, your emotions, that's the energy you put out there.
Mm-hmm.
So if you are, even though you're trying to fake it,
yeah,
and you think you're doing a pretty good job of faking it, but if underneath you're feeling guilty mm-hmm. about anything, that is the energy you're putting out there. And the really interesting thing is, Stacey, the emotion of energy, you know, how everything has energy to it.
Yeah.
And energy, you know, is a frequency. So everything is at a different frequency.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Guilt as an emotion is the lowest frequency of all emotions.
Yeah, I believe that.
Yeah.
It's sluggish.
Yes.
It keeps you stuck.
Yes. Yeah. So that's exactly what's happening. And you cannot fake it.
Yeah.
Right? So people might not be able to put their finger on it.
How have Catholics survived for years? Because we feel guilty about everything.
Absolutely. And honestly, I think that's a shift that needs to happen.
Yeah.
With traditional religion, mm-hmm. is that we need to like release the yeah. guilt and the shame.
Yeah, absolutely.
And the fear, you know.
Yeah.
That's my opinion.
Gosh. So now you can help people. You can come into corporate settings. You can come into businesses. You can come into groups and you can talk to them, and people can take your classes.
Yes.
There's so many ways people can get a hold of you. What all do you offer, Mary Jo?
Right now, my focus is on speaking
mm-hmm.
and then the Secret University.
Mm-hmm.
So you can enroll in that. And for this month, it's half price.
Which is great.
Yep. One-time payment gets you a lifetime access.
Yeah.
And that is like a combination of working one-on-one with me mm-hmm. to become aware of your limiting beliefs so that you can start releasing some of that crap.
Yeah.
And then really let your, what I call like, let your light shine. So you're hiding right now
mm-hmm.
underneath the guilt and the feeling alone and the sadness. Just let that all go. And then really start focusing on what you do want, what you want your career plan to be, and then yeah. how to bring that in to your reality. Because it can yeah. be done.
Absolutely.
And we can do that all through enrolling in the Secret University.
Okay, so how can people do that, Mary Jo?
You can find out everything you need by going to my website, thesecretformula.us.
Awesome. And do you have a phone number or any way, other way that they can give you a call if they have any questions?
Yes, that's all on my okay. website.
So just go to thesecretuniversity.us.
Yes.
And then all the info is there.
Yes.
Awesome. Half price for August. So get signed up. Don't wait. Don't hesitate, because before you know it, August is going to be up.
That's right.
It never fails. The last day of August, your phone's going to be ringing off the hook. People are going to be just like today.
Yep.
Everyone's messaging me, do you have tickets to the event tonight? And I'm like, no, we're almost sold out. Yeah. Then they yeah. act like it's your fault.
Yep.
Come on, people. Yep. Get on it.
Enroll and you can get that next promotion.
Absolutely. All right. So check it out. TheSecretUniversity.us. Mary Jo Van Horn with The Secret University. Thanks so much for coming in today.
Oh, thank you.